But anyway, we find out that people go to get the fix people that do crazy things. Then why the root man got so much power? Why he got to get the people? Amen. If he got so much power, why is he got to get people to give him some money? Tell people some lie, huh? Mm-hmm. Thank the Lord. Maybe them roots ain't working, and maybe it's a mind thing. Amen. Mm-hmm. Thank the Lord. But the Bible do speaks of roots now. Mm-hmm. Amen. But I see so much evil in people. People coming up and people doing crazy things. So I kind of like, you know, the Bible said putting out your trust in man, man didn't deceive you. I'm kind of like learning a lot of things about that, because some things you better not tempt the Lord thy God. Amen. But the Bible said, tempt not the Lord thy God. So evil spirits do is this. People can dislike you, and people can try to hurt you. Amen. People can hurt you. Amen. They can set out and they can be jealous of you and they can hurt you. Amen. Thank you. You can't believe every spirit. Amen. I'm going on, y'all. I'm going to say that to you. I don't want to stay too long on it. Amen. But this spirit, these demons that was in this man, they were legion. And what they said to Jesus said, Jesus, don't cast us out of this area. There's demons in this area. That's what Bishop West was saying. So there's demons in this area, and they don't want to give this little town of Brooksville up. He said, they got this thing going on. We don't want no churches, and we don't want nobody to be saved. We want the people that we have all the honky-tonks and cussing and going on with the rap music and all this stuff. So we want that, but we don't want churches. Amen? Mm-hmm. So in this region, this little region here, that everybody that come through here, because back then my granddaddy, he had a juke joint called the Blue Moon. Man, they partied, had the gambling casinos and all that. So if it's so much gambling, I mean, they rocked it, man. They back then. I remember my little boy in that big old place. So all that been generational things. Mm-hmm. You understand? So it ain't nobody about no church, man. Used to be Bethlehem was the only church, black church around here. Bethlehem, right down there. And it wasn't a lot of churches. So all of a sudden, these people getting churches and young people want to get saved and getting saved. We didn't know about all this stuff, man. So the demons been set up to come up against ministry. Amen? Mm-hmm. When we came up here, I never forget a little thing was done to our church and little thing, because they don't want church. They don't want to hear them at church. They want to get high.
That's it.
Dope and alcohol and all that stuff. Bring that on, brother. Amen? Thank the Lord. So you got to understand what's going on. When you understand what's happening in your town, your city, you know what you're up against. Amen? So I learned this down through the years. Amen? I said this just to let you know where I'm at. Sometimes it's them demons that cause people to act all kind of unseemly ways. They don't understand it because it was generational. So when a man like me come, or somebody elder than me, come up there, the man of God, and preaching against sin, they don't like it. So what happens when you see so much things that are happening in our life and so many people that are dying and people getting killed and stuff, God is saying it may be that one that might have said something against a church or something against a man of God. So things happen to people. That's why you got, if you do anything, if you got an ought against that person, or say something about a preacher or anybody, man of God, you need to make it right. Amen? Right quick. Amen? Because people are dying sometimes because they spoke against a church, against a minister, against a man of God, and they leave in here. It's no respected person. Young, old, boy, woman, man, boy, girl. It's happening. Amen? Thank the Lord. So when the demons go to messing up and causing people to do crazy things, you read in the paper how people are killing people with no reason and just going to start shooting people. That's demons, man. Those forces are real. Amen? That's an unclean spirit that caused somebody to kill somebody, takes a person alive. Amen? Thank the Lord. I'm going on, y'all. I got to go. Amen? Mm-hmm. Go back home. Go home to your family. Amen? Thank the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The demon said, "Don't. We don't want to leave this region. We don't want to leave this area." Amen. And the Bible said in 11th verse, a large herd of pigs. I'm in the Everyday Bible, yo. The large herd of pigs was eating on a hill near there. The evil spirit begged Jesus, "Send us into the pigs. Let us go into them." So Jesus allowed them to do this. Mm-hmm. And the evil spirit left the man and went into the pigs. Mm-hmm. Then the herd of pigs rushed down the hill.
Amen.
Rushed down to the hill into the lake and were drowned. There were about 2,000 pigs in the herd, in that herd. Good God Almighty. Now, when Jesus, it's interesting. If you think I have to listen to this real carefully, because they said, send us, the demons said, send us into the swines. I like to say King James, that's where it said. Mm-hmm. Send us into the swines.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus said, okay, if you're going to cast us out this region, let us go into the swines.
That's it.
There was a field of pigs out there. And Jesus said, okay, I'm going to let you, wait, that's where you want to go? The pig, the demon spirit left the man and went into the pigs.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible said it was about 2,000 of them.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden, the demon spirits caused them to run into the lake. This spirit, once it went into the pig, caused the pig to run to the lake and drown all 2,000 little pigs. Go back home to your family. Thank you, Lord. Woo! Glory be to God. Go home to your family.
Mm-hmm.
All 2,000 of the pigs, the herd of pigs was drowned.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord. Them demons said, we don't want to live in no swine.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll drown ourselves. See, once the demon know, see, they was me with the man body. But we don't want to be in no swine. Thank you, Lord. So let us kill ourselves.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Go back home to your family. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let's go on to the 16th verse. I'm going to close it. Amen. Thank the Lord. Then some people were there. I'm skipping y'all. Some people were there who saw what Jesus had done.
Mm-hmm.
They told others what had happened to the man.
Yeah.
So, they told what happened to the man who had the demons living in him. And they also told about the pigs. And then the people began to beg Jesus to leave. Good God Almighty, this leave that area. Now you see that now? The word got out what Jesus had did, that he cast them demons out of their man. I wish you see this here. Some of them saw firsthand what was done. Some of the people witnessed it. The power of God. And how they knew that the man was demon possessed. We knew that this was a man that had legion of demons. He said, we are legion. And they seen firsthand how Jesus cast the demons out. They asked that the demons, they asked, can we go into the swine? And how Jesus said, okay, and the demon went into the pig, and the pig went down in a big lake, all 2,000, and drowned all the pig was drowned, the herd of pig. Some of them seen it. So we seen what Jesus did.
Mm-hmm.
But now we want him to leave this area. Too much church.
Mm-hmm.
Too much God. We don't need all this here. And the people said, we want you to leave. Now, can you see what's going on? Anything for right, people don't want to have nothing to do with you. I wish you see this now. The Bible said that the people began to beg Jesus,
mm-hmm,
leave our area. Now, you would think that they would want somebody like this, a man of God. Exactly what I told you.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want churches. Matter of fact, they would say, we got too many churches.
Mm-hmm.
They would go around saying to them, just like George said other times, that we ain't got too many jug guns. That's what they want.
Mm-hmm.
They want the honky-tonks, and you can't get too much of honky-tonks, man. Put them up, alcohol, the bars and everything, to get permit to get the alcohol and all that there. No problem.
That's it.
They'll house you by getting a permit to put a shed up. But the man can go down and get a liquor license the same day. You can get more alcohol and all that, and they see you drinking and stuff. You see how converted life and how people